Ladies and gentlemen,
come gather around, come gather around, come gather around.
Today, for our LS Swap 61 Chevy pickup, we gotta hook up the drive-by-wire pedal. Let's go!
So I like to always try things out by tracing out the object or mocking it up in cardboard or breakfast cereal or something. Some folks joke this is CAD, cardboard-assisted drafting. But honestly, I'm just tracing out the pedal mount and then trying to figure out what I need to do to make this work. This pedal is, I believe, from a roughly early mid-2000s Chevy Silverado pickup. And it's the way it's shaped, I guess, fits under the dash of the Chevy of its vintage, but it doesn't exactly fit the more vertical dashboard firewall of my 61. So I'm trying to figure out what kind of shape, what kind of angle I need to make this pedal feel comfortable under your shoe, but also be able to go all the way down to the floor to be full throttle. Takes a little bit of messing around. I am tracing out onto, I believe it's 18 gauge, I believe it's galvanized sheet metal. A lot of the metal I use for patches on the 61 Chevy in the sheet metal fab. I may try to remember to put a video up above for fixing a lot of rust patches with that. At any rate, drilling some holes to make it mountable. There are two square kind of pegs on the backside. You don't want to put a square peg in a round hole. That's just silly talk. Or me in elementary school. And so I drilled where they are going to be, and then I'm going to file them square, because I strangely don't have any square drill bits. I know the wood guys have square drill bits. I don't know how that works. And I was using gloves. I use gloves. Don't use gloves. Gloves are dangerous. I'll still probably use gloves. So adjusting some of the holes here and seeing how it fits and then playing with it and seeing how it fits and playing with it and seeing how it fits and playing with it. Nice thing about files is they can kind of sneak up to the size, the final size you need it to be. I think in this case I'm using a triangle file because it happens to be the one that I have that actually fits. Takes a while, but it works. An interesting note, and this I guess is a little bit of foreshadowing. While this pedal is from whatever year, let's say an 06, I think it's an 06 Chevy truck, the 07 Chevy van that my computer came from will not talk to anything but an 07 Chevy van pedal and an 07 Chevy van throttle actuator module. So, like, I got a book on LS swaps, engine swaps and stuff, and it says, oh yeah, these are all kind of interchangeable. No, they're not. The van computer will not talk to an 08 van pedal or an 06 or even whatever. It's just, holy smokes. So, if you're getting stuff to do a swap, get exactly the year and the model for the computer that you have. You're gonna be happier with that. Anyways, we've got this thing going back together, and what you see on my workbench here are a bunch of, I call them dimple dies, I think. And I machined a bunch of these. If you want a set of plans for those, just fire a comment down below and I'll look at putting together a video on making them and give you a set of plans. They're really pretty simple. I think I have these at a 30 degree angle. You can probably do a 45. And I designed these exactly spaced to fit 16 gauge sheet metal, but honestly, it really doesn't matter a whole lot. They're just mild steel. You can get the hardened stuff if you want, but you know, I'm not a business. Using a hole saw, I pre-drilled quarter inch for the pilot hole just to as a guide. And then hole saws. When you're using a hole saw, these are designed for wood. I'm not cutting wood, so you want to be kind of gentle. And I tend to run these hole saws through steel until all the teeth are gone. It's surprising how far you can send these drills, these hole saws, before they're finally no good at all. I think I machined all the teeth off of one and then used it as something for pressing on the hydraulic press. At any rate, I've got a bunch of sizes for my dimple dies, and then you can do them in a hydraulic press. This metal's thin enough that I just do them in a vise. You could probably do them with a C clamp. One time at C camp, but I drill a hole through these, so I could use like a half inch bolt and some big fat washers. I never have, but I designed it to do it that way. I cleaned up the burr from a hole saw with a deburring tool and a little bit of a surfacing disc or 2-inch abrasive disc. And then we dimple them. It's like that easy. Looks cool. It's lighter. Puts rigidity into a flat panel. And pretty much nobody will see it under the truck except me. Sheet metal brake. If you want to make one of these for yourself, I have a set of plans. I'll try to put the link to the video where you can watch the fabrication of it. But then you discover once you're folding all this that, ah, crud, I can't fold the last side. So this is a piece of 1/2-inch round with a hacksawed slot in it, and I can start the edge and then beat the rest of it over the corner of my workbench and get it nice and flat. So you can fold stuff even if you don't have a sheet metal folder. It works. And I think I ran this, ran some existing holes and screws and fasteners to make it all attach. It eventually gets epoxy primed, painted interior body color, and the gas pedal is mounted. Fits really nice. I like the truck pedal. The truck pedal does not talk to the van computer, but that's a later video.
So, pedal's in, mounted, hooked up. Does it work? I don't know. We're like this far away from getting all the wiring done and having this little beastie run. So stick around and let's make this thing a reality. Thanks for watching. Take care and we'll see you again. Oh, I gotta get past you here. Hang on, excuse me. All right, coming through.